You'll never try, you'll never know, right? What? I only have one day to prepare.
I'm totally lost.
Because I know that I will have the result. My hands are trembling.
Wow. Wait. A lot of languages.
I got the internship.
I'll be strong.
Hey guys, this is the series of videos where I share my experience in searching for and finding my first internship in tech industry as a software developer. During this period, I recorded videos where I shared my experience, my thoughts, my plans, and my doubts about searching for the first internship. So, enjoy.
Hello world. It's been a while since I recorded this kind of videos the last time, but you will not know that. I will try to upload them regularly, but this is the 27th of March, and I don't really remember when was the last time I recorded a video. And anything new happened? I don't really know. So these days, since the recording of the last video, they were really tough, and one day, like today, when the sun is shining and the birds are singing and it's finally spring in Moscow, I feel so inspired and I feel like I can do anything. I am, I don't know, I'm a superwoman, superhero, and I should apply for any job position, anything, like the top companies will hire me for sure because I'm good. And the other day I wake up and I'm like, oh no, I know nothing. Nobody will want me to work in their company. I should probably get the computer science degree. I'm small and I feel like so desperate these days. This kind of, like, I don't know, it's a sort of swinging from one side to another and changing your mood every time. And yeah, this kind of imposter syndrome on the one side and super confidence on the other one. And I don't know, like, but the only thing I'm sure, like, how do I work on that and what do I do in order to find the balance between this kind of things is just action. And first things, like, I'm enrolled in 21 school, like franchising school of 42, and I realized that for sure I will get the internship thanks to the school. It will not be that fast as I want, but it will be, and I need to admit it. If you are from 42 watching this video or kind of familiar with their system with Black Hole, in 21 it's a little bit different, so we don't have this counter of days when you can stay at school, and instead of that we have, and we can't freeze our account. And instead of that, we have a deadline system according to the papers we signed. It's more motivating, I think, but at the same time, a little bit, it like places you into this limits. And sometimes I feel kind of stressful with the fact that, oh my gosh, the deadline is near and I should learn very fast and pass my projects and so on. And for some people who combine it with their other projects with the work, it's very hard. And so I don't know, so it's kind of two effects on that. But the thing is that I can see, the good thing is that I can see when exactly is the time when I can finally get my internship. And the school assists with searching for the internships, and I don't know the exact system in France but and in other countries, but I think it's kind of the same. So in Moscow we have, like, when you reach the sixth level, you will be added to the kind of channels in Slack, I guess, and they send you different job positions, job offers, opportunities, I don't know, but you yourself apply for them, of course. And then at certain date, you need to like go and validate this internship. And so here are the dates, right? Right now I have the fifth level, and the deadline is the 30th of March, which is very close. Like, I got a fifth level, and also we need to pass exams, and I passed the fifth exam on the 24th of March, so, which is kind of very close to deadline. Then the sixth level is on 27th of June, and the sixth exam as well. So it means that by 27th of June, I'll be added to this channel and I will have these opportunities for internships. And by 26th of September, I'll have to get the 10th level and pass the final project, like, and to reach the common circle. So anyway, it means that I will get the internship by the end of this summer. And it's not like a very long period. And at the same time, I also feel like nostalgic feelings of school, because I've spent so much time there the last couple of months. And the thing is that, like, I really enjoy this time in school. And so probably I should concentrate and feel these moments, this precious time there. And of course, school gives me a lot of competence, a lot of hard skills, community, everything. But at the same time, I really want to find the internship as faster as I can, and also have this, at least have this experience of job interviews. Honestly, I've never had the real job interview in my life, and so that's why it's kind of scary for me. And that's why I think I'll have this kind of swinging mood all of the time, because when I imagine me having this process of interview, I always have this, oh my god, they should test me and ask me different questions, and what should I do if I don't know the answers. So and how I also try to live with this kind of emotions is the action, as I probably told you. So what I did is, like I told you, I think in the previous video, that I kind of tried to design my GitHub and make it public. And so that's why, like, I add some descriptions to the projects and readme files. If you need some kind of guide for that, I will put down the link below in this video. And GitHub itself, I think it provides kind of syntax for readme file and how to make headlines, the bold text, kind of code things. And I also look at the other students' projects, how do they design them, like not design, just how do they write readme files, and kind of try to create my own, but using their ideas as well. And I also, yesterday, I finally almost finished my CV. And if you think that you spend a lot of time on making a proper CV, no, you don't spend a lot of time. I think I spent 3 hours on making one page. And I haven't finished yet. I think I'm gonna make some changes. The most difficult thing was like to kind of formulate my thoughts and make it very structured and make it very short, because nobody will care about like your entire biography in 2 pages. And also I needed to include only coding related stuff there, probably languages. So if it's gonna work, this CV, I'll also, why not sharing it with you, and it's gonna be a template for you probably. And I make it like very good looking thing, but I think it's no problem if you make it just simple. Yesterday, I asked my friend his first CV, and he sent it to me, and it was very simple, like headlines, no design, just a bunch of stuff listed, but it was relevant and it was crucial, I think, that that it is relevant, that it is short, and everything the employer that employer needs is included in your CV. So that's kind of it. My friend really inspired me to apply, finally apply for it. Today I'm gonna apply for a ByteDance company, I think. They have a lot of, not a lot of, but some positions for interns and junior positions, and why not to try? There, it's written there that you need to have, you need to currently pursue a bachelor or master degree in computer science or related field, but and I hope that it will not be a barrier here, and they will at least ask me for the interview process, which I really need in order to get this kind of experience. So, long story short, I think like I really need to get this experience anyway, and when I have this kind of thoughts in my mind, I feel so inspired, but then comes this imposter syndrome, and which kind of disappoints me every time. But the only thing you should care about is the action, and I will act. Yeah, and promise here right now, today I'm gonna do it. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if you want to support me somehow, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed yet. Share this video with your friends or who are interested in coding, programming, career changing, and also follow your dreams as I do, and you'll make it one day or another. Thank you and have a good day. Bye bye.